Here at the Late Show, we talk about whatever we want. You know, my name's on the building, nobody asks questions. But one of our self-imposed mandates is that if we can, we talk about what everybody's talking about. And today, what everybody's talking about is something that's pretty hard to talk about, and that's Israel and Gaza. Since Hamas attacked Israel on October 7th, the world has seen the horrible, inhuman cost of this conflict. And there was passionate disagreement in this country about what is the best way for Israelis and Palestinians to achieve a peaceful and prosperous future. I'm sure there are disagreements in this room, but I hope there is one thing we can all agree on. Human beings should have food and water. Well, here's the thing. On Monday, 7 World Central Kitchen aid workers were killed by an Israeli airstrike in Gaza. Our thoughts are with the families and the loved ones of these heroes. And please forgive me if I mispronounce any of their names. Safadin Isam Ayad Abu Taha, John Chapman, Jacob Flickinger, Zomi Frankom, James Henderson, James Kirby, and Damien Sobel. Now, how could something like this happen? Despite the fact that the World Central Kitchen coordinated their movements with the Israeli military and the team was leaving a warehouse in central Gaza after unloading shipments of food, they were hit by multiple precision Israeli drone strikes. They were riding 3 vehicles, including 2 armored cars carrying the World Central Kitchen logo on the roof. Now, Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu claimed it was a mistake, but he wasn't exactly apologetic.
Unfortunately, in the last day, there was a tragic case of our forces unintentionally hitting innocent people in the Gaza Strip. This happens in wartime.
Nothing just happens. You are responsible. If your answer is this happens in war, then maybe consider ending the war. Because this is not... this is not an isolated incident. On top of the thousands and thousands of innocent lives that have been lost, more than 200 aid workers have been killed in Gaza since the war began. And as many of you know, the World Central Kitchen is near and dear to my heart. It was founded by our friend Chef Jose Andres to bring food to hungry people after natural disasters and in war zones. Jose addressed the situation today in a beautiful op-ed in the New York Times titled, "Let People Eat." In the op-ed, Jose makes it clear that World Central Kitchen doesn't take sides. Their work is based on the simple belief that food is a universal human right. It is not conditional on being good or bad, rich or poor, left or right. We do not ask what religion you belong to. We just ask how many meals you need. And they walk the walk. So far, in this conflict, World Central Kitchen has delivered 1.75 million hot meals in Israel and 43 million meals in Gaza. I mean, they get in there with the food, and they do the job. They're like SEAL Team DoorDash.